Hello, this is Nino, and I'm here to show you the gift wrapping geometry node setup in Blender. And this is the file that it comes with. We've got three collections. We've got the scene that basically includes the floor, the background, and those things. We've got the gift wrapper that includes the geometry node setups and a collection called object to wrap, which is where you will place your object or collection that you want to wrap up. We've also got the wrapper GeoNodes collection, and that includes all the files and the geometry node setup for the ribbon and the wrapping itself. And then we've got some testing models. Right, so how does this work? Well, it's very easy. All that you will need is the object to wrap collection. And what you want to do is grab any object, for example, this default sphere, and let me show you how the scene looks. The sphere is the default one. If I drag and drop this into the object to wrap, it will wrap it up instantly and nicely, add materials, add a ribbon, and add the bow on top. The fun thing is we can do this with multiple objects. So if I grab this cone and drag it next to the sphere in the object to wrap collection, it will wrap them both together in one single wrapping. And I can update this live. For example, if I move this cone around, it will continue to wrap them up together, and it will move the ribbon with it around them as well. So that's quite nice. Right, so we can also do this with entire collections. For example, if we want to wrap up an RV, drag and drop, and it will wrap it up, just like that. One final one, for example, this little airplane, drag and drop, and there we go. Beautiful. Okay, so let's test out some of the settings that we've got. And I'm going to test it out with Suzanne. There we go. Drag and drop Suzanne into the object to wrap. Nice and smooth. There we go. And you can see that if you change the scale of Suzanne, the wrapper will move it with it as well. There we go. Amazing. And if we go to the wrapper itself and go to the geometry nodes, you have some different options. First one is your origin object. And this is by default set on the origin. And the origin is just an object that I added to the scene that is somewhere near the world origin. But you can see that if we move Suzanne, that your ribbon and your bow will try to stay somewhere in the middle. And it isn't really what you want if you actually want to move this object around. So what we do in that case is just go to your wrapper and change the origin object to the object that you're wrapping. So Suzanne. In this case, you have to do the same thing for the ribbon. Change the origin object to Suzanne, and there we go. For collections, you will change this to your parent object. Okay, so now if you move Suzanne around, everything will move with it nicely. If you rotate Suzanne, it will try to stay on top your ribbon, and that's just something that I like. I like the ribbon to be on top of your gift. And there we go. So you can always just apply your entire geometry node setup and then move everything together, rotate everything together if you have everything in the spot that you want it to be. And let's move this back a little bit to the center. There we go. Let's select our wrapper and the option and then after is the wrapper size. So you can imagine if you have a wrapper and it's too small, it will not be able to cover your entire object. Same thing goes for this. If I decrease this, it is going to, at some point, be too small for Suzanne. And we can see this in a second. If I move this a little bit faster, there we go. So now it's not going to be able to wrap your entire object, and it's just going to be too small. Just like when in real life you have the wrapper too small, it can't cover your object. Right, so you have to play around with that a little bit. Next up is the wrapping offset, which will basically just offset your wrapping from your object a little bit. And then we've got the wrapping detail. So what this does is basically add detail to your wrapper so it gets closer to that actual shape of the object that you want to wrap. And the first one I don't really use because it's not that special, but the second one will really bring it closer. So if I up this, you can see that it now takes much more the shape of the Suzanne head. You can up this one more time to 3. It gets a little bit slower, but it gets the trick done. You can see that the material changed a little bit as well because it UV unwraps at the last step of this wrapping. And if I change this wrapper size a little bit, that material, that UV unwrapping will change as well. So make sure that if your materials look weird, the wrapping looks weird, that you just change this wrapper size a little bit. All right, just until it wraps it up nicely and the materials look clean as well. All right, I'm going to set this back to, let's say, 2, maybe 1, because we're going to change some more of the settings. I think 1 will do for now. Okay, so let's see. The next option is the shade smooth. Sometimes you may want to see those hard lines, those papery wrinkles that you have when you wrap an actual object in real life as well. So there's always some wrinkles, some cracks, and some things like that. So it's not always that smooth. I'm going to leave this off. And next up, we've got the smooth. So what this does is just smoothen out your mesh a little bit. And when I set this to 0, it will get a little bit closer to the shape of Suzanne, but you will get these hard edges. So I like to have this set at somewhat of a repeat factor. You can play around with that for yourself. Okay, next up, the second geometry node setup for the wrapping is basically the material. So it unwraps it after it wraps around your object. UV unwraps it, and then you can change the scale, make it bigger, make it smaller, whatever you like. And you can change the material, of course. So for example, I've included 12 wrapping materials right now, and they're from the Blender kit. I made some changes to it to make it possible to use with geometry nodes. But you can see that all of those materials, they look quite nice on this object. Right, so let's see. There we go. And now we're going to get to the fun part, which is the actual ribbon. And so the ribbon has more options. There's more ways to customize the ribbon. The first one, you've got the origin object. We already went over that. But then we've got the resolution. You don't need that much for simple objects. Ribbon resolution. So for Suzanne, I think 45 was enough. Yeah, it's plenty to go around your object. If you have a more detailed object that you are wrapping, or a larger collection, you may need to add that detail to higher levels. For the second one, we've got the width resolution, which basically means how many loops there are in this direction. And I think 10 is usually enough. But if you, for example, are wrapping around a cube, you may only need 1 because it's a straight line. But you can imagine that if you have more advanced, more detailed objects, then you need just a little bit more geometry. So make sure that you keep that in mind. Next, the ribbon scale. Scale up your entire ribbon. Scale it down. If you want it to be very thin, you can make it happen. There we go. We got the width of the ribbon, of course. So you can pretty much wrap your entire object in the ribbon itself. And that is something you can play around with. The ribbon thickness as well. Make it thicker, of course. The Y location of the ribbon and the X location. And this is where it gets fun. So you can choose the position of your ribbon on your object, and the bow on top will move with it as well. And you can do this for the Y direction and for the X direction, just like that. Beautiful. All right, so let's set this back to 0 for now. And the next one, we can change the size of the bow tie. Of course, if you want a big bow, you can make it happen. Location, I don't really change this unless something doesn't really work out, and let's see if I can make that happen. So for example, if I change this Y location, usually it does it quite well, but sometimes you can see that it bugs out a little bit. And if you want this specific position, then you can just change the offset a little bit to make it go back to that center, right? So keep that in mind. Next up, rotation. Rotate it around the Z axis, for example, and that axis will change with the rotation of your bow. So the bow tie will keep its rotation to the normals of the top of the ribbon, and the Z location will basically be that normal direction, right? So it will rotate around that. Then we've got the ribbon material. We can change that to whatever we want as well. We've got a few ribbons included. I can show you some of these materials, and they are basically very smooth and metallic, shiny materials. I've also got this one, which is a little bit less shiny. You can change those materials according to your likes, of course. And I'm just going to, let's see, something purple would be nice here. There we go. Yeah, that matches quite nicely. And I think that's pretty much all the settings that we have to go over. The last one is the ribbon distance, which basically just offsets your ribbon a little bit from your geometry. Right, there's just one more setting to go over, and that's the realize to apply. And let's say, for example, that you want to use the wrapper and ribbon in a different Blender file in a different scene, then you would have to convert the wrapper and ribbon to a mesh, so it actually becomes an object, an actual mesh. And you would, for the ribbon, have to set this realize to apply to 1 if you want to convert this to a mesh. Otherwise, it won't include the bow on top, because that is an instance. So you can leave this as 0 as long as you're making changes, and set this to 1 only if you want to apply the geometry nodes, if you want to convert it to a mesh. Setting it to 1 makes the changes that you're making in the geometry nodes a little bit slower. So make sure to set that to 0 as long as you're making changes, and just set it to 1 if you want to apply it. So if I set this to 1 now, I can just apply these geometry nodes, and now we've got the ribbon. Beautiful. For the wrapper, it is very simple. You won't have to change anything. You can just apply everything. Apply, apply. And then you will have these two objects as a separate objects that you can use anywhere you want. Beautiful. Now you may think, can I use this geometry node setup in a different file? Well, the answer is yes. So if I now want this to append in a different scene, this is the default scene, I can just file, append. I'm going to look for my gift wrapper. I am in the blend file right now. So let me just go back. So we've got the gift wrapper. If we go to collections, we've got the gift wrapper as a collection there. You just append that. There we go. And it will append with Suzanne by default, with the default objects as well. And if you now want to use this on any other object in your scene, let's say this cube, the thing we can do is just drag Suzanne out of the objects to wrap collection, just like you would otherwise. And now we can just select that cube instead. So just search for the cube and drag that into the objects to wrap. Now you can't see anything changing, and that is because the origin object is not set. So if you go to ribbon and go to the modifier and you set your origin object to the cube like that, and for the wrapping as well, set the origin object to cube, there we go, then your wrapper will go to your object. And you can just scale your object, you can do whatever you want. Make sure that if you scale it too big, you actually change the wrapper size, of course, to cover your object. There we go. And you can do whatever you want with it, and the wrapper and ribbons will move with it. So you can just append it to any scene and use it for any object in that scene as well, as long as you set those origins right in both the geometry nodes. Okay, so that's pretty much it. You can use this however you see fit for whatever you want. Make sure to make some fun presents for the holidays as well. I hope you have happy holidays in advance, and I hope you enjoy this modifier setup, this geometry node setup. Thank you.